Congrats on your new Cisco Business Wireless CBW150 access point. Whether you're upgrading your office infrastructure or setting up a new workspace, it offers the speed and reliability you need to keep your projects on track. It uses the 802.11ax standard, also known as Wi-Fi 6, and offers a data rate of up to 1.2 gigabytes per second on its 5 gigahertz radio, exceeding the rates of previous standards. Key features include the uplink, downlink OFDMA, orthogonal frequency division multiple access, a technology that allows Wi-Fi networks to send and receive more data efficiently by using multiple channels at the same time. It also has downlink MU-MIMO, multi-user, multiple input, multiple output technology, allowing the access point to send data to multiple devices at the same time, improving network efficiency and speed. In this episode of Cisco Tech Talk, I'll demonstrate the day zero configurations on a CBW150 access point. Next. Before I start, I need to point out that the CBW150 access points are not compatible with the previous business series that included the CBW140, 145, and 240 models. Therefore, coexistence on the same LAN is not supported. To begin, make sure you do not have an active VPN connection. Go to the toolbar at the bottom of your screen and look for available Wi-Fi networks. Select the one named Cisco Business Setup and click Connect. It will prompt you for the network security key. Using no capital letters or spaces, enter Cisco 123 and click Next. It is important to note that only one device can be connected to this network. If a second device attempts to connect, it will not be able to. If you're unable to connect to the SSID and have validated the password, some other device may have made the connection. Restart the AP and try again. Click on Start to create a username and an admin password. Be sure to note this information, as you will need it to access the graphical user interface of the primary access point. Use the Show Password feature to ensure you are entering the same password in both fields, and click Start. Now, proceed to set up the primary access point. Select the appropriate country, date, and time zone, and make sure they are correct. If you are in the Mountain time zone, adjust the setting accordingly. There's an option for those who have mesh extenders. If you are not using them, leave this option disabled. You will also have the option to create a static IP for your primary AP connection between the access points. In the next step, you can customize the network name. Leave the security settings as default and enter a passphrase of your choice. Make sure to note it, as it will be needed later. Check that you have entered the same information in both password fields, then click Next. A summary will be displayed, showing the configuration details, including primary IP settings, username, AP name, and network name. The network name is crucial, so note it before clicking Apply. Upon applying, you will receive a message about the primary access point rebooting. The reboot process can take 6 to 10 minutes, during which various LED statuses will be displayed. For details on the meaning of these, click the link in the description. Once the reboot is complete, return to the toolbar and check the Wi-Fi connections. You should no longer see the Cisco Business Setup network, but instead see your newly created network name, such as Admin Network. Go to Available Wi-Fi Networks, select the network you created, and enter your password. Once connected, navigate to the ciscobusiness.cisco interface. Use the admin username and password you set up to gain access to the graphical user interface of the primary access point. That's all there is to it. The initial setup of your AP is complete. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.